ani kroku dalej Wiedźminie.
Gdzie jest Renfri?
Pod wieżą. Składa czarownikowi pewną propozycję.
Parental Advisory, Slavic Content. The Witcher is a fantasy drama series streaming on Netflix, based on the series of books by the Polish version of J.R.R. Tolkien, Andrzej Sapkowski. The whole premise takes place on a fictional land known as the Continent, and we follow the stories of three protagonists who are connected to each other by the most powerful magical source in the said continent, known as
Destiny.
If you haven't watched the series, know that there are two seasons available right now on our beloved streaming service. If you intend to watch them, then click away, because
spoilers are right ahead.
Well, before I jump ahead into the long anticipated season 2, allow me to quickly break down season 1 and where it left us. Hanging for 2 years.
First time.
Season 1 was a little bit complicated for us normies that turn off our brain while watching a show. It basically has 3 separate timelines for each of our characters. Yennefer's story happens way back before everybody else's does. Geralt's is sort of in the middle, and Ciri's story happens in the present. And to figure this shit out, it took me 3 fucking episodes. I wasn't even tipsy. Anyways, we see from the get-go all the struggles that Yenna goes through in order to obtain power and beauty, her humble and heartbreaking beginnings, and the sacrifices she makes in order to get back what she lost, the choice of becoming a mother. In the distant future, Geralt is just minding his own business, until his path leads him to the city of Blaviken, where he learns through Renfri that the girl in the woods is his
destiny
and he can't escape it. After a little time jump, Geralt finds himself in a banquet at Sintra, where he ends up saving Ciri's father, Dúni, who in return asks the Witcher to take a reward. Geralt, being a jester he is, invokes the law of
surprise, motherfucker,
which is basically like giving something that you have, but you don't know that you have it yet. Naturally, they find out Pavetta, Dúni's now wife, is pregnant with his child, so basically, Geralt claimed Dúni's daughter as a payment for saving his life. That's fucked up. After a while, Yenna's timeline catches up with Geralt's and they end up meeting. The whole segment happens as this. Geralt has insomnia, he finds a genie, he unknowingly releases a genie and has 3 wishes. He makes a wish that gets his companion, Jaskier, sick, which results in him seeking magical aid and accidentally bumping into the sorceress, known as Yennefer of Vingerberg. She in turn seizes the opportunity to use the genie and tries to become its vessel. The genie tries to kill her, but Geralt saves the day by uniting their
destinies
through his 3rd wish. Without Yenna's consent.
How dare you!
After a while, their paths cross again, and Yenna finds out the truth about his 3rd wish through a dragon. Yeah, it's a long story. Watch season 1 yourself. She gets mad and basically breaks up with Geralt.
Eventually,
we catch up to Ciri's timeline, which happens in the present. The young princess is a refugee from Sintra, which has been sacked by Nilfgaard, and she is on the run to find Geralt, who she was told by her grandmother that is her
destiny.
By the end of season 1, Yenna and the Brotherhood of Sorceresses manage to stop the Nilfgaardian march to the Northern Kingdoms at the Battle of Soden, where her fate is left unknown. On the other hand, Geralt and Ciri finally meet each other, as it was foretold by Renfri in the woods. Now season 2 kicks off strong with its 1st episode, then it drops
hard.
The whole thing gets messy and it seems as if the writers have
no fucking
idea what they want to do with Yenna's character. Geralt and Ciri's act is interesting and being built upon. But it gets interrupted by Yennefer's boring arc of losing her magical mojo after burning the whole Soden to a crisp. Her whole journey can be summarized like this.
No mana. You have no mana, bitch. You have no mana!
Now that we got the majority of Yenna's plot out of the way,
know your fucking place, trash!
Let's focus on the saving grail of the season, Geralt and Ciri. We first find them on the road to Kaer Morhen, crossing the battlefield of Soden looking for Yenna. They stumble across Tisea, who presumes Yenna's death. After some time, they come across Nivelen, an old friend of Geralt, who was cursed to look like a beast from a certain fairy tale, because he destroyed a temple while being high on mushrooms? Well, Geralt smells something fishy, so he goes on to investigate. After some digging, he concludes that Nivelen has a Bruxa in his house. This forces Geralt to grab Ciri, pack his shit up, and
move now.
In the end, a fight breaks out. Ciri tries to save the Bruxa, it goes south. Nivelen interferes by backstabbing the monster, and Geralt gets the kill steal. As a result, the curse is lifted, and we figure out that the Bruxa loved Nivelen, despite the fact that he did some questionable deeds with the priestess of the temple. In disgust, our heroes leave the keep and hit the road. Finally, we arrive to Kaer Morhen and get to meet other witchers like Vesemir, Lambert, Coen, and Eskil. Блять! They did him dirty! They turned my boy into Groot! Anyway, let's not lose focus. Yenna meets up with the Baba Yaga ripoff. Back to Kaer Morhen. We have a bachelor happening where the witchers
summon the bitches!
The whole party ends abruptly by Eskil's transformation into a Groot. Lich. Forcing Geralt to put him out of his misery. After that shit show, we have Ciri's training montage and the elves moving into Sintra, and on the other hand, Geralt is trying to take revenge on the leshy that was responsible for Eskil's demise. Alas, a centipede kills the leshy. Geralt gets annoyed and pesticides the insectoid. We have Triss arriving to Kaer Morhen. She helps Ciri with her training and Geralt with his investigation. They find the connection between the monoliths and the monsters, and Geralt is portaled to Istred to get more answers. Meanwhile, Vesemir discovers that Ciri is the key to creating more witchers. Also, we have Dijkstra and Philippa, who are plotting on Redanian's behalf to cause unrest in Sintra. Oh, and Yenna bumps into Jaskier. Here we meet Rince, who tortures Jaskier to get info on Ciri. The most interesting part of the episode is Ciri finding out the truth about the origin of her magical powers. Then she tries to broker a deal with Papa Vesemir, who reluctantly agrees. Why? This premise is
stupid.
They're not.
She's the only way they can produce more witchers. Allegedly, he is willing to risk her life by allowing her to go through the trial of grasses.
What?
Only 3 out of 10 boys survive that shit.
I like those odds.
At the same time, Geralt plays the archaeologist with the magical rocks.
Now they're minerals, Jesus Marie.
Furthermore, Yenna makes a pact with Baba Yaga. They meet each other. Geralt gets a good fighting sequence that's pretty lit, and Yenna gets away with Cirilla. So, now that Yenna and Ciri ported away, Geralt seeks some answers about his lover's plan to give away his adopted daughter to a demon. Anyhow, he locates and frees Jaskier, who spills the tea about Yen's motivations. They recruit the dwarves from the previous season, catch up with the ladies outside of Sintra after saving them from some Nilfgaardian forces. Yen's consciousness kicks in, she regrets her decisions. It's too late for that, you're irredeemable. The demon somehow escapes the hut, magically finds Ciri and possesses her. The final episode opens up with Ciri being on
killing spree
in Kaer Morhen. The surviving witchers, Yen and Jaskier, try to enact the whole exorcist thing. They manage to do so thanks to Yen. She offers to become the vessel, after apologizing to Ciri. Yeah, I'm not buying that shit. Later on, we have Ciri porting them to an unknown world, where the demon leaves Yen's body. We get a glimpse of the Wild Hunt's cosplayers. Then, they port back to Kaer Morhen. Everybody figures out Ciri's origins, and we learn that Duni is the Emperor of Nilfgaard. Listen, there is so much going on this season that I couldn't give two shits about. The whole Elven story arc? Scrap it. Fringilla story arc and Arethusa? Scrap it. This isn't Game of Thrones, it's The Witcher! The story should be revolving around Geralt, Yen and Ciri. The other characters don't matter unless and until they cross our hero's path. But it's just my opinion. I've only played the game, so what the fuck do I know? Although it seems that the book readers ended happy with the adaptation since it derails from the source material. Basically, the books are the original story. The games are a fanfic future of the book somewhat, and the Netflix show is its own separate property.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have been the most beautiful audience. Remember to toss a coin if you can. If anyone needs me, I'll be at the bar.
My beautiful people, hit that like button, subscribe, and also hit the notification bell, so you are always aware when Uncle Yuri is pumping out new content. Until next time.
Destiny.
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 Destiny can go.
I'm getting out of here.